Over winter break, I decided to delve into the world of speedrunning. For those who don't know, speedrunning is the art of completing a specific task in a video game, most of the time beating the final boss, as fast as possible. Now, mind you, this is more than just beating a game quickly. For example, let's look at Skyrim. In the opening, the game wants you to jump down into this building, make your way through the chaos, and go into Helgen Keep. But let's look at what the world record speedrunner known as Waz does. Like any normal player would do, they jump onto this unintentional ledge here, go across the walls, set a quick save here, dash to where one would normally exit the dungeon, saving, then loading their quick save, this time entering the keep like normal to get their hands untied, quick saving, loading the save on the outside, then using a load warp glitch. And to explain, these two saves have two different characters, one on the outside and one with their hands freed. But we need both of these things on one character. The glitch takes the one with free hands and warps them to where the other one is on the outside, therefore skipping the dungeon and saving tons of time. If you don't understand a word of what I just said, that's okay. This is to show that speedrunning is not just playing fast, but instead a series of specific techniques and sometimes glitches in order to make your time as slim as possible. It is a competitive community, but most people in it would be glad to teach you how to get started. And speedrun.com, the most popular speedrun site you'll find, has a whole page on what you need. First, a timer program, and I'd recommend LiveSplit because it has integration with speedrun.com. Second, a screen recording software to record the run, and there are plenty of options, like OBS Studio. And obviously, you need to pick a game and category to run, and watch other runs to learn the techniques. Since speedrunning is so complicated, I thought the best way to present this topic to a bunch of people who may or may not have ever watched a speedrun would be to introduce my own first run to you all. For my first rodeo, the game I chose was Westerado Double Barrel. The objective is to find the person who murdered your character's family and get revenge. And I chose this game because I already knew the fastest way to do it, I just never properly speedrun. As you play, you get more clues as to who the murderer is, but if you do a specific mission, you'll get all the details immediately. You'll want to have done a slow, normal playthrough to get familiar with it. For this particular game, you will want to have done the railroad side quest and unlock the sister character, because she starts with both a revolver and a shotgun, which is very important. The timer starts when you press anything to go past this first dialogue box, which is... now. First, sprint to Rancher Bob's place and talk to him to receive this mission to protect his buffalo. But shooting the buffalo and failing on purpose just means we don't get money and is way faster, especially if you have the shotgun. From there, he wants you to get some other ranchers for another job. You need to talk to at least one, but for the other two, it is faster to shoot their hats and make them mad at you. Shooting near them doesn't work, and killing them will cause a dialogue that will lose you a couple of seconds. You start the mission, and again, it is much faster to shoot Rancher Bob and fail. He retreats, you go back to his ranch. Now, the one rancher you recruited has been shot by the murderer and describes them, giving you all the details. You go back to town, shoot somebody, and if the murderer is close, he will come running and flee. His location is random, but I've found if they're in Clintville and close to the horse, you can find him very quickly, but you do just need to get lucky. From there is the finale, the murderer's hideout, a linear segment where you run around and flip some switches, but you can just run past the majority of enemies. The world record holder does a crazy glitch here where they skip a lot of ground by clipping into the wall, but I'm not able to pull that off myself. Shoot some dudes, do this sequence we need to follow the right guy based on visual, go in this corner to easily shotgun these guys, follow him until the end of the line, beat him in a gunfight, and finish the game. I kept trying and got faster and faster, and after dozens of tries, I managed to get my time as low as 5 minutes and 21 seconds. Submitted it to speedrun.com and waited. As a moderator needs to watch your run and make sure you followed the category's rules and didn't cheat, typically between 1 to 3 weeks. I am happy to announce that almost 3 weeks later, my run was verified by a mod and accepted onto the official boards, originally making me 15th out of 26, but since then someone else has beaten my time, making me 16th out of 27 as of this recording. That may not sound impressive, but it takes a lot of effort to get even that far. The guy in second place for this game actually congratulated me on it and gave me some advice.
Everyone in this community has been super friendly and they've made it such a good time, and I have no doubt you'd experience the same.
Overall, I had lots of fun and would love to get further into this awesome hobby. I'm already trying to find time to practice for a run for a different game, but that's a story for another day. If you want to see more, you can look on speedrun.com for your favorite games, or you can check out events like Games Done Quick. It hosts a variety of runners and does stuff for charity, and it's really cool. I'd highly recommend it. I'd also recommend you check out other people on YouTube who talk about speedrunning with detail that I don't have the time or knowledge for. Seriously, just look up whatever game you want and then speedrunning, and you'll almost certainly find something cool. Though I'm proud of what I accomplished, it was a pretty small feat compared to people who will attempt a run literally thousands of times to just shave off a fraction of a second, which is dedication that needs to be admired. So if my brief tale interested you, then absolutely look into other people's stories. I hope you all learn something new, and maybe someday you'll see my name higher up on the boards. I'll see you then.